Hi, it's Chris Jenock here. It's CES 2024. I've just come from the Samsung Innovation Room. We'll give you a little summary. You're not allowed to take photos or videos inside, so I'll have to give you a little verbal summary of what I saw in there. For the most part, it was is pretty similar to what they showed at IFA last September. You can see some of the videos I recorded after visiting there. I'll put those down below. Let's see. They started out with the microLED demo, which featured their 89-inch microLED TV, which I have called the new gold standard for microLED TVs. So the presentation was essentially the same, showing some of the technology that they put into this. Again, you can see the video to get more details on it. They next brought in a guy named Powell Ochtel. A cinematographer I've known for some time. He has a very high-end camera, a 9K by 7K camera, which is kind of, again, a gold standard in terms of cinematography. He was there to talk about 8K capture and why this space is important. And his main takeaway, I think, or main emphasis in his presentation was that 8K content should be captured in a different way than traditional movies are captured today. Today you want to capture things that are, you know, 3 to 5 seconds long, a lot of cuts, but for 8K content you want to capture more like an IMAX screen or a giant screen cinema capture content, where it's much more immersive, it's larger, you live in the scene for much longer, so these are longer takes, and he thinks that's kind of the sweet spot for where really 8K capture and 8K production is going to land. And, you know, with the advent of the Sphere here in Las Vegas and other planned spheres and other immersive entertainment that's coming around, he may have a really good point in that regard. That may kind of drive this more immersive environment, and that will benefit larger 8K screens for the home going forward. There was also a demo of some of the upscaling technology that they've improved for this year's 8K TVs. They've expanded the neural network. Samsung points out that they're the only ones that actually include a dedicated neural network in their upscaling TVs. And specifically for the 8K TV, they've gone from 16 neural network. From 64 element neural network to a 256 element neural network. And they showed some demonstrations of how it can upscale even 720p content to pretty good-looking 8K content, which certainly has been an issue with 720 and 1080p content in previous generations of 8K TV. So that's a big improvement. They also talked about some of the improvements in the image quality for their 4K TVs. Those were kind of subtle, frankly, a little bit better color accuracy, some less ghosting and banding when you have letterbox content, more color, color accuracy, and some frame rate improvements as well. So, for example, when you have compression that takes the frame rate down for sports content, you can see a judder and a ball moving across the screen, for example. So they've improved that with their processing. Moving on to their OLED screens, they've introduced a new anti-glare technology, and they highlighted the ability to really reduce the glare from ambient lights by having two spotlights on a traditional OLED and spotlight on a on their new anti-glare screen. This apparently is basically a diffusion screen that they've added in the front. Now, the issue with diffusion screens is they can potentially reduce the sharpness to make the image look a little bit softer. But the trick is to have just the right thickness of that diffusion screen. Too thin and it doesn't do much. Too thick and it will soften the image. So according to Florian, who's looked at the technologies pretty carefully, they've actually done a really good job of optimizing that film, so there is no loss of clarity. But it does do a really good job of reducing that that reflections from lights in the room or windows, whatever that may be. New this year is a new standard that Samsung and others are going to be pushing forward, in particular Google. So this is called the IAMF, which stands for the Immersive Audio Model and Format. This is essentially a reaction to Dolby Atmos. So Dolby Atmos is a royalty-bearing technology for immersive sound. This IAMF, well, that's a mouthful, isn't it? IAMF is the reaction for Dolby Atmos. So IAMF will be royalty-free, whereas the Atmos is royalty-bearing. And this is going to be standardized through AOM, the, what does it stand for? The, well, it's the compression group that Apple and Google and many others are a member of. So they will start to have the ability to look at this audio format now. And according to Samsung, they'll start to roll this out in 2024. You do not need to have an Atmos style soundbar to do this. It can be supported in legacy speaker systems. So with a firmware update, Samsung will support previous generation TVs. I'm not sure how far back that will go with this format. And YouTube is supposed to start to roll out content with this new audio format this year as well. So this is a important and kind of a surprising development, very similar to what Samsung did with their HDR10 Plus format as a reaction to Dolby Vision, for example, royalty-free versus royalty. The other thing that they showed, which is also kind of interesting for their Frame TVs, the Frame TV, of course, is supposed to have very nice, accurate colors and a very matte finish, so it has a paper-like look and can display artwork with really good fidelity. One of the issues with that is it's very dependent on the ambient illumination. So if you have, for example, if you calibrated the Frame TV to D65 and you have a D65 light source in the room, colors are accurate. But if the lighting is different, you go to an incandescent bulb or a fluorescent bulb at various color temperatures, the perception of those colors changes. And so they had a demo with Pantone colors that clearly you could change the lighting sources and your perception of those colors will change. The same thing will happen on the Frame TV. The perception of the colors on the artwork will change. So now they have a calibration procedure that I apparently can evaluate the spectrum of the light source, and it will adjust the colors on the Frame TV to bring it to match the perception that you would see in that lighting environment. So that's pretty cool innovation. That is pretty much the summary of what they showed in their innovation room. If I learn some more, I'll let you know. Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media.